إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، قول الله سبحانه وتعالى: كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Allah Azza wa Jalla speaks in Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed the month of fasting for the believers, for the Muslims, as He has done so for the people in the past, with the common objective that everybody can become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How so? By attaining taqwa. What is it? Meaning being conscious about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being aware of His presence all the time, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meticulously knowing that Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching over me, I need to be conscious about it. And this is another discussion about Ihsan. One of the definition of Ihsan, then when Jibreel asked Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبرني عن الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The message is that act like that you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you don't, which you don't, be sure that Allah is watching over you. وَكَانَ رَبُّكَ بَصِيرًا. Allah is watching over you. So being meticulously cautious all the time that Allah is watching over me. That is one of the objectives of fasting in the month of Ramadan. Fasting was not designed to lose weight, neither save money, or other elements associated with that. Objective was, and only one objective, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you can be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم. Same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, month of Ramadan الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, a special month in which the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla was revealed. What kind of book is this? القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. A special book was revealed in a special month, which is a criterion which shows the difference between good and bad, haq and batil, from right, from the left, from the path towards Jannah, from the path towards Jahannam. We ask Allah's protection from us. So this is the month of Ramadan, which is special. First we discuss, inshallah, a few of the virtues. I'm sure you heard it many times because this is the season of Ramadan. Like everybody talk about the virtue. So we'll talk a few minutes about the virtues and some of the actions we should be trying to do as a person, as a family, as a community, inshallah. Ramadan came with a common objective because this is the pillar of the religion. Ali Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam buni al-Islamu ala khamsin. Islam was built on five pillars. If anybody saw a tent, right, tents are built with certain pillars. At least they have one pillar in the middle. And houses has pillars on all sides to carry the weight and distribute it and take to the earth. These pillars are designed to uphold the house. The tiles in the wall are for beauty. Carpet is for beauty. Those pillars are the vital element for the very existence of this structure, of this architecture. Islam is built on five pillars, and they are designed to uphold the banner of the religion. Very fundamentals, and one of them is fasting. So what is the objective of this religion? يقول الله عز وجل وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah عز وجل created you and me
and the jinn with only one objective. Not many objectives, and this is one of them, that's not the case. Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ, I did not create the men and the jinn. إِلَّا exclusively for one purpose. So it is better be clear on our mind that our purpose is not to eat. Our purpose is not to go to college. Our purpose is not to get married. These are the part of the process supposed to support our ultimate and the only objective, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from morning to night. But do I mean you pray 24 hours a day? Answer is no. But we live a life that is within the boundaries of the religion that in turn will translate to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well as fulfillment of ubudiyyah, objective of the creation of Allah azza wa jalla. So Ramadan came with a common objective as a pillar of the religion, so must uphold the structure of the religion. Structure is every person is conscious about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 24 hours of life is guided by the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As human, we are deficient and we are going to fall short. So how do I make it up for it? By tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As soon as I make tawbah, in essence, I have come back to the obedience of Allah and fulfillment of the requirement of ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ramadan came with common objective like salah, like sadaqah, like zakah, like hajj. That must bring the person at the fundamental, at the core of the religion, which is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, it could be another discussion. Can obedience could be a random event? No. Obedience is a structured event based upon kitab or sunnah, upon the exclusive understanding of the companions and the first three generations, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. طيب, that's another discussion. Fasting has so much benefit. Any ibadah, this came in Sahih Muslim, any ibadah of a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get reward 10 times up to 700 times. But if Allah gives 7 million, nobody can stop it because يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يَفْعَلُ مَا يُرِيدُ, I do whatever I please. Nobody, he subhanahu wa ta'ala, has to answer to. But by the book, in academic discussion, any ibadah get 10 times to 700 times of hasanat. 700 times. For example, it is not with Ramadan, it's any time of the year. Somebody give $1 to the masjid, $1 to a poor person, see a sick person in the hospital, you can get 10 visits of hasanat to 700 times of visiting a sick person. Allah is that merciful. إِنَّ اللَّهَ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ, Allah has favored His creation so much. And this is one of them. But guess what? But Ramadan is such a special ibadah. No other ibadah come close to it. No other ibadah come close to it. Because 10 to 700 times is for ibadah like salah, zakah, and hajj, and so on and so forth. The ibadah, as-sawmu li, وَأَنَا أَجْزِ بِي أَوْقَمَ قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنْ حَدِيثِ الْقُدْسِ, Allah Azza wa Jal said, fasting is exclusively for me, all ibadah is for him anyway, but exclusively Allah chose this one, that fasting is for me, and I am going to reward about the fasting himself, no number associated with that. Let us repeat this. No number associated with that. Like $1 give you $700, no number associated with that. Hajj, inshallah, which is accepted hajj, you forgive all of the previous sins. This is a number or some benefit, fadail, associated with that. Fasting, as-sawmu li, fasting is for me. Wa ana ajzi bi, yaqul Allah azza wa jalla. Rabbus samawati wal ard, the Lord of the universe, saying, it is for me, I will reward it in a special manner. How? He subhanahu wa ta'ala knows only. What is the point? Point is, we should not take this month like any other month. Point is this, day of this month, we should be like any other, it cannot be like any other days of the month. Night of this month cannot be like any other nights of month. Because يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى, in this month, ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. In this month, there is a night. In the last 10 odd nights, meaning last 5 odd nights, there is a night, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, it is so blessed, is equal to, in a number value, over 1,000 months. Does it really mean 1,000 in numbers? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, I do not know. But fact remains, at least if we consider, it is 1,000 months, if I consider that, that would be 1,000 months over 83 years, many people don't even live that long. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died in age 63. Abu Bakr likewise, radiallahu ta'ala. So therefore, many people don't even make that much. And Allah Azza wa Jalla benefited us that if you're serious about it, one night searching for it. But let me tell you something, because any time you say something in khutbah in a short time, there's always somebody going to flip the script and think other way around. So I don't pray whole year and look for one night. Nobody is saying that. That's ridiculous to say. Because, as I started with, Ramadan came with the objective to make a servant obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the objective of this creation, by the way. Salah is the same objective. Fasting is the same objective. Hajj is the same objective. So if you are playing games whole year and come on one night, doesn't fulfill the objective. So this is just playing games. But will Allah forgive you? It is between you and Him. But as far as I am concerned, I don't like to play like that. Why not? Let me give you an academic example. I have students, I know, on the first day of the class, by the second day of the semester, I know this person is going to fail. Not because I know ghaib, because the experience of dealing with people. The student comes late in the class, failing the quizzes, don't do the homework, don't do the lab. What do you think? The person going to get A? No, it doesn't make sense. Unless a miracle happened overnight, which really happened yet. Right? Really happened. So, a Muslim playing games all their life and do everything out of the book and expect to come one night and play with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لَا تَتَّخُذُ آيَةِ اللَّهِ هُزُوَى. Do not take the word of Allah as entertainment. This is not game. وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَةِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا لَاعِبِينَ. Surah Dukhan, surah number 44, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Allah did not create the earth and heaven to entertain, to play around. So this is surely not a joke. This is a serious business. So every Muslim with consciousness must take this month serious. So shall I work? This is my opinion now. This is not Sharia. This is my opinion. What I'm about to say now. My opinion is this. If somebody work this month like any other month, my understanding, this is my opinion, right? This is not Sharia. My opinion, the person is not sticking this month serious. This is my understanding. If every month the way the person sleeps and sleep the same way this month, my understanding, the person is not taking it seriously. Does it mean that Ramadan is invalid? Definitely not. Ramadan is valid. But I'm going to say, I like to maximize my benefit, optimize my process. This is how we look at it. Like in stock market, people want to buy wealth, buy stock in a low price, as soon as it goes high in the top, just drop it and collect all the benefit, right? I'm not validating stock market because I don't know. That's another study of Islamic economics. I don't know how many of them good or not. That's another topic. But this topic here is people want to benefit. Short time, want to make a lot of money. That's did you want to make money in a month, a million? People want to do that. Allah has offered you a better deal than that. هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ. Shall I not guide to a bargain, a business? This is a month of business. A Muslim people should be business oriented. Now they're sitting back, laying back, watching other people making business. That's really silly. So every person must look at this month of opportunity. Take every second of it. I walk into the house as if I don't know anybody. What happened? Because Allah has prescribed a month for me. Something serious happened. What happened? This is a month I have to get close to Him. Because I've been so far, for so long, 11 months, this is the month I must come close to Him. So your son said, what happened to you, daddy? With this month is Ramadan, my son, because I'm worried about hellfire. I get to get something done this month. Your wife said, why are you not talking? Because I have to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because I missed Him for so long. Your wife says, I don't have time to cook so much. This one food should be enough. I think half is enough. Because we ate so long. That's why most of the Muslims are obese. I saw a stat. A lot of Muslim countries obese. I myself has problems. Muslim high cholesterol, high triglyceride, many medical problems because excessive eating, improper eating, not following the sunnah. If we follow sunnah, which I don't, may Allah forgive me for that, eating one third of the stomach, we should be doing that. We don't need any medical doctors. If you exercise a little, it's fine. But if you eat so little and burn all the calories up and eat healthy, you don't need anything else. But you do exact opposite and suffer many consequences. That's beside the discussion. The point is, this month should be a month. Rasulullah is to tighten his belt. So you got to get ready for a month. We have to take a shot. This may be the only shot we have. Many people who lived the last Ramadan may not live this Ramadan because we still have a few days left. And many people will die in the next 3-4 days, by the way. So nothing is guaranteed. So as a Muslim, still have 3 months, 3 days to plan for it. And the Muslim who should have planned from Shawwal, last Shawwal. Last Shawwal, when this Ramadan comes, I'm ready for this. I'm not going to let a minute pass. So my talk will be limited. My email transaction, unless it's a business, will be limited. My text, only business. Anyway, I only don't text and talk to the people unless this is a business or religion, period. Period. I don't call from this phone to anyone unless there's a business relation, official business, or religious talk. Otherwise, bye-bye. There's no point talking because we have enough luggage with ourselves to be answered day of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, day of judgment. So why are you going to extend it further? Right? So we have to be cautious about ourselves. Life is very expensive. Life is very expensive. We need to use them carefully. But some of the fadail, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man sama Ramadan. إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وقام قال صلى الله عليه وسلم This hadith came in Bukhari and Muslim. Another hadith similar type, من قام ليلة القدر. من whoever stay up in ليلة القدر at night. من قام رمضان. Also another hadith, whoever stay up at night in Ramadan. Same thing, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وقام قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever put some dedication in this month for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive all minor sins, inshaAllah. And the major sins require tawbah from Allah SWT. Or making a hajj, inshaAllah. Those who fast the month of Ramadan with due diligence and follows that by something else, they get additional bonus. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان ثم اتبعه ستة من الشوال كان كسهم الدار أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever fasts this month of Ramadan and follows that fasting by 6 days of Shawwal, they will get reward as if they fasted the whole year. Now, obviously, once you say that, a small issue of fiqh comes up, so I must address that. Now, somebody couldn't fast because of sickness, or sisters couldn't fast of biological reasons. And do they fast those first or the Shawwal first? There's an ikhtilaf among the ulama in this regard, a lengthy discussion. I'm an academic, I give you both sides of the story, not one-sided. Fiqh, practically speaking, not any single opinion in fiqh, practically speaking, has one opinion. Majority cases of ikhtilaf, majority. Those who study further, they see the difference. Those at basic level, only see one part of the story. So I'm saying, some of the ulama said you could do the 6 days, in case the month passes, then you do make up the obligatory ones. Some of the ulama said, because hadith, the text, the language said, thumma, that means it must be followed by Ramadan. So if you didn't fast the whole Ramadan, that means you didn't complete the Ramadan. Upon the completion of the Ramadan, then you should add that six. And I believe that is closer, a stronger of the opinion, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best. طيب. Now another opinion, also discussion will come into it, many people ask, that sister who are nursing or pregnant, do they have to fast or give fidya only? Ulama has obviously differed in this matter in great detail. In great detail in this. Opinion of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the fidya is enough. But this is not the majority opinion. So I really don't know which is the strongest because these are kibar of the ulama, kibar. So we have no understanding close to them. So by studying between the two, I still believe a pregnant woman had to fast when she relieves her load, that means the baby is born, then down the line she has to fast, she doesn't have to give the fidya. But if anybody follow that opinion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alam Allah is the best. So you decide based on what you're comfortable with, not what is easy for you. Here's the difference. What you're comfortable with in understanding, studying the fiqh, not what is easy for you. Looking for easy way out, that's not the objective. This religion is easy, yes, but not as per your definition on Allah and His Prophet, right? Some Muslim brother said, you know, deen is easy, I can make Jummah. Akhi, you cannot make this rule. So, I mean, come on. I mean, what is this? This is a philosophy class now? You just decide as you please? Now, it is easy, but it has some method, some process involved to it. That's another discussion, because each of them is a discussion by his own merit. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this month for a special purpose. Month of Ramadan is connected to the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. In this month, the book of Allah is revealed. A powerful book. A powerful book. How powerful the book is, unless I explain in one word, it won't be enough to understand. Let us visualize what kind of book I'm talking about. Start with ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This is a book in which there is no doubt. Therefore, there is no revision on that. This book came once and remains as it is. نحن نزلنا الذكر إن له لحافظون. I have revealed the book, Allah said, and I am going to protect it. A book doesn't require revision. The book will not go through any change because Allah is protecting it. That kind of book. So this is the characteristic of the book. What is the weight of the book? يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Hashr, Surah number 59, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل. If I reveal this book upon a mountain, لا رأيته خاشيا متصديا من خشية الله. This Allah, if He revealed this book, Kalamullah, this is not a creation of Allah. This is the word of Allah Azza wa Jalla, Rabbul Alameen. Now, if He revealed this book upon a mountain, لَرَيْتَهُ خَاشِيًا مُتَصَدِّيًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَدْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if I reveal this book upon a mountain, it would crumble. It would crumble out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I was looking at a video of the Himalayas, the mountain, which is about 29,000 feet, the summit of it, 29,000 feet high. Looking at some geological studies on that. So I was looking at a video of that. SubhanAllah, I look at the mountain, so much mass of it, the height of it. Allahu Akbar, you just look at the mountain. You are little, as little. A 6 foot high person is this, and mountain is 29,000 feet up. You don't even exist in front of a mountain. That high, aircraft, normal aircraft 747 flies about 30,000 and up, that altitude, 33, 34, 35, 36K, that feet. Imagine the height of it, the mass of it. Allah said, mountain like this would have crumbled out of the fear and awe of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, why do I even tell you this story? Did the book come on a mountain? Answer is no. Did the mountain crumble? Answer is no. So why discuss this, something that didn't happen? Just to describe the magnitude of the Quran. So we understand, Allah said, Allah gave this example for humankind to reflect on. Allah gave this example so we think about it. This is not a newspaper. This is not a biology book or a chemistry book. This is not any other book. This is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It requires some level of respect to it. Not respect on hugging it, but studying it, understanding with sincerity and applying in life. That's what the book demands from us. How come the Muslim has neglected the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How come the book of Allah collecting dust and Muslim indulging in something else? Ask a young Muslim, come fringe college, ask them about Allah and His Prophet, the person is dumbfounded. Surah Rum, Surah number 30, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةُ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. They are expert in the matters of the dunya, but when you ask them about Akhirah, about Allah and His Prophet, they're dumb. Why so? Why Muslim are like this? And Muslim wonder why we're suffering. I don't wonder. I'm wondering why you're not suffering more. Wallahi lazim, Allah is my witness. This is not a lecture. I wonder, subhanAllah, how come we don't suffer more? How come not? How come I don't suffer more? Wallahi lazim, I ask that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much mistakes been done through the ages of life. But Allah has shown us favor over and over again, hiding the sins and forgiving it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eloquently says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. Allah has favored His servant so much, and we've been so ungrateful to Him. So ungrateful to Him. Is it not the time a Muslim need to take this one series? Come back to the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Revive the thoughts that we have to be a Muslim now. Enough is enough. Time clock is ticking. It is getting too late. This month, let us take the opportunity to love on Allah's Prophet and expend some time getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah wa li wa lakum. Inna alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa mawala. Again, as the time is short, this Quran, Allah said, Hudan lil muttaqin. The Quran, to get benefit out of it, you need to have some taqwa. And taqwa comes from this month. Allah said, La'allakum tattaqun. So those who benefit from this month, equally will benefit from the Quran. So these are integrated, connected together. So this month, Muslims should culture themselves to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what happened? That there is a disease in our heart, Therefore, we don't benefit from the Quran, neither from the month of Ramadan. يقول الله عز وجل إنها لا تعمل أبصار ولكن تعمل قلوب التي في الصدور. Allah says it is not the blindness of the eyes, rather it is the blindness of the heart. That deficiency causing us not to get benefit from it. If you get an orange and lick from an outer shell of the orange, you don't taste anything because you have to go into it. Our heart is diseased or diseased, I don't know. We have a major problem in there. Therefore, taqwa sits here. At-taqwa ha-huna, kama qal sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Taqwa, fear of Allah, consciousness about Allah, sits in the heart. Sits in the heart. If the heart is deficient, we can benefit from it. So we need to work on it. One of the example, what happened in the heart, is how you manifest ourselves outwardly. A Muslim playing loud music in the month of Ramadan, any month is wrong by the way, but the month of Ramadan playing loud music passing by, the person has a problem in the heart. Sister is backbiting, brother is backbiting, month of Ramadan, problem in the heart. The sister walking without hijab, problem in the heart. There is a major problem. A Muslim selling in the business pork and wine and khanzir and khamra, wallahi this Allah made it haram, how dare? How dare? I repeat, how dare? You live in the earth of Allah Azza wa Jal. You live in the earth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and blatantly just ignoring the rule of Allah Azza wa Jal, don't even care His rule. Like He's nothing. I don't care. Allah said, don't do it. He said, who cares? I am going to do it. If you're that arrogant, get out from the earth and heaven, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you're that arrogant, يَا مَاشَرَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ إِنْ إِسْتَطَعْتُ مَنْ تَنْفُذُ مِنْ أَقْطَارِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فَانْفُذُوا لَا تَنْفُذَنَ إِلَّا بِسُلْطَانِ. If you don't like it, take a hike somewhere else. And you can. So better be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least starting from this month. Fine. Now next point. Why don't you benefit from salah? I'm giving an analogy of Ramadan. Salah with the khushu has benefit. قَدَفْ لِحَدْ مُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاةٍ خَاشِينَ. Successful are those of the believers who have khushu in their salah. Khushu cannot come unless you know in front of whom you're standing. Khushu is consciousness, fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla. You don't get it unless you know in front of whom you're standing. If you go to the court and judge is looking at you, you're like, yes, your majesty, your honor, humble, focus. Why? Because you know the power of the man or the woman. But Allah is the Lord of the world. Doesn't He deserve a little more than that? That's why we make salah has no khushu, no benefit. Ramadan likewise means nothing to us. So we need to change our mind before we do some action. So today I'm not saying do some action. I'm saying prepare the mind to do some action. That's step number one, changing the mind. The way we approach month of Ramadan, the way we approach Salah and Zakah and Hajj, it becomes too ritualistic. We need something more than that. Fire. To conclude the message, the young men and women, if there is any, that month of Ramadan, this phone, such a useless element for Muslims. It has some benefit. Believe it. You just don't know how much benefit from it. Most of my Islamic work done on my phone. Study, summarizing, notes and everything on my phone. Beneficial thing. And I have people, students back of the class doing texting, Facebook and surfing the net, and they are the one failing. Because you don't pay attention to something important, get distracted by something unimportant, you lose the value and the goal and your target. Month of Ramadan is important, that's your goal. If the phone, or the job, or the family, or your car, anything else distracts you from that, you need to put a brake on it for now. At least a month, till you get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in a personal level, every person should focus for this. And those who are work, you work for yourself, you have the freedom to take off. I would advise everyone, if possible, to take last 10 days, if not at least last odd nights to take off. Those who are professionals, you get vacation saved up, should take 10 days off, these 10 days. Try hard to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who come i'tikaf in the masjid, please don't make it a social gathering. House of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah said clearly, إِنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُ مَا اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. House of Allah is specially designed and designated for His ibadah. For His ibadah, not a social club. Yes, we can have social events, but this doesn't turn to a social club. So it is a sanctuary. So you come here, should feel. You get in with the dua, get out with the dua. This is a special place. Yes, this has four walls. This is a house. Yes, I know that. It's not news to me. But when you convert to a masjid, this becomes a special place. Those who come here, they're special. Those who give food and water, they're special. Those who clean the masjid and the bathroom, they're special to Allah. May not be to me, may not be to you. Khalas doesn't matter. But to Allah, they're special. So you are in a special place doing a special thing. Guess what? You need to act special also. That's my point. So those who are coming in the Ramadan in the masjid, every masjid in Ramadan should be vibrant. It should be vibrant all the time, especially in Ramadan. Many duruz, many askar, many reminder of Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not sitting down, lay back, eat and sleep. Has to have more than that. So every Muslim must focus. And to conclude the matter, none of the above could be done. None of the above could be done unless the person have the knowledge of the subject matter. What to do, why to do and how to do it. So every Muslim must work hard in this month, dedicate themselves to study certain books. I'm going to finish this many books. Honestly speaking, that's what my practice for God knows how many, maybe 25, 30 years. Ramadan, Etikaf, these four books I'm going to finish, summarize my understanding on it. Take this. And this is what I have to do. That's how I build the base of knowledge. Without the knowledge, you don't know Allah. If you don't know Allah, you don't love Him, you don't fear Him. If you don't love Him or fear Him, how can you worship Him? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Muslim should try to do as much as he can. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the heart and guide us to the right path. We ask Allah azza wa jal give the Muslim ummah the proper understanding and knowledge and the sincerity and effort they can go to subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa qawli hadha astaghfirullah wa li wa lakum. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana israfana fi amrina wa sabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ihsin aqibatana fi al-umur kulliha wa ajirna min khizy ad-dunya wa adhab al-akhirah. Allahumma rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. Allahumma rabbi irhamhuma kama ربنا صغيرة اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربنا صغيرة اللهم ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة عين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما اقيموا الصلاة رحمكم الله